Hello friends, in this video I will show you how we can configure a router as a DHCP server, okay, so that the router will distribute the IP addresses to the devices across the network. So first we will make a topology here. So here I will make it two LANs, LAN 1 and LAN 2, and connect these two LANs with the router and make the router as a DHCP server, okay. So here I will take two switches, one switch for LAN 1 and one switch for LAN 2. Here I will make local area network 1, and on the right side I will make a local area network 2, okay, and take one router also. This is a DHCP router, okay. It will distribute the IP address across the network. Connect all the cables. So before configuring the DHCP router, I will show you these PCs don't have the IP address. So go to IP configuration. You can see here there is no static IP and no DHCP IP. Okay. Once you click to DHCP, it is showing the DHCP IP field. It is taking the IP by address, means it is not able to get the DHCP IP. Now let's check on this side whether these PCs are getting the DHCP IP. Just wait. Here also you can see it is getting the IP by address, means not getting the DHCP IP. Okay, so we will configure the router as a DHCP server. So this router will give the IP addresses dynamically across the network. So here on this interface, gigabit 0x0, I am giving the IP address of 192.168.0.1. okay. And on the other interface of the router, that is gigabit 0x1, I am giving the different IP network IP address, that is 192.168.10.1. So the router will distribute this network IP address to LAN 2, okay. So now go to the router, click CLI, and in the dialog box type no here and press enter. Here type the command enable to go to the privilege mode. Now go to global configuration mode. Here give the IP address to the interface gigabit 0x0. You can see here, select the interface gigabit 0x0, IP address 192.168.0.1, and give the subnet mask as well, 255.255.255.0. press enter and give the command no shut to make the interface up. You can see here the gigabit 0x0 interface is up. You can see here the link is now up. Now give the IP address to this interface also, gigabit 0x1. Exit from here. Interface gigabit 0x1. Give the IP address. Here I will give the different IP address, 192.168.10.1, and subnet mask 255.255.255.0. And give the command no shutdown to make the interface up. You can see the gigabit 0x1 also now up. So now I will make this router as a DHCP server. Okay, so I will mark here this router is a DHCP server router. Okay, so this router will distribute the IP address across to these networks, okay, LAN 1 and LAN 2. So go to the router here, go to global configuration. Here we have to exclude the two IPs that is connecting to router interface. See here, 192.168.0.1 and 192.168.10.1. okay, these two IPs we have to exclude from the DHCP server, okay. So to exclude the IP address, give the command IP DHCP excluded address. and give the IP which we had to exclude 192.168.0.1, and again same command but give the different IP, that is 192.168.10.1. okay, now these two IP addresses will be excluded from the DHCP server. Now make a DHCP pool. Okay, to make a DHCP pool, give the command IP DHCP pool and the pool name. Here I am giving the pool name as LAN1. Now give the command network space network address, that is 192.168.0.0, and subnet mask 255.255.255.0, and press enter. Now give the command default router, that is router IP default gateway IP. Okay, default router IP, that is 192.168.0.1. Press enter. If you want to give the DNS server IP, you can give DNS server IP. Here I am taking the IP 1.1.1.1. Exit from here and make another pool for LAN 2 also. Okay, give the same command IP DHCP pool space LAN 2. Press enter. Now give the command network space network address of other interface, that is 192.168.10.0 space subnet mask 255.255.255.0. press enter. Now give the command default router space default gateway IP, that is 192.168.10.1, so that the DHCP server will assign this default gateway to the clients. Now give the DNS server IP also. Give the command DNS server space give the IP 1.1.1.1. press enter. Exit here. Okay, so to check the configuration, give the command show running configuration. You can see here the excluded addresses from the DHCP server and the DHCP pool you can see for LAN1, and the network address you can see 192.168.0.0, and you can see the other pool for LAN2 and the network address 192.168.10.0. Now let's check whether the PC clients are able to get the dynamic IP from the DHCP router. Go to machine here, go to IP configuration. You can see this PC is able to get the IP from the DHCP router server. Okay, again check the DHCP box. You can see it is showing DHCP request successfully. Okay, this PC got the IP from the DHCP server router. Okay, now check the other PC as well. Go to desktop IP configuration, click the DHCP box. So this PC also able to get the IP from the DHCP server. Now we will check the other PCs of LAN2. These PCs will get the different network IP address from the DHCP server router. Okay, 192.168.10.1 IP this PC will get. Okay, go to this PC machine, go to IP configuration. You can see this PC got the different network IP 192.168.10.2. okay, again click DHCP. You can see DHCP request successful. Okay, now check the other PC as well. Go to desktop IP configuration. Now check the DHCP box radio box here. You will get this PC will get the dynamic IP, okay, from the DHCP router. You can see here this PC got the IP, and you can see the default gateway also 192.168.10.1 and DNS server 1.1.1.1. okay, so this is how we can configure a router as a DHCP server so that this router will distribute the IP address across the network. Okay,
so friends, if you find this video helpful,
Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.